Hello guys, and welcome back to my dual socket 370 motherboard that has been fully restored and tested and now is accompanied by the components that will be living with it in this classic beige tower case. We have a 5.25-inch front panel speaker USB audio out thingy, which I think is pretty cool, a selection of CD drives, and a 3.5-inch CF card reader. Two sticks of PC133 SDRAM, one stick is 512 MB and the other is 64 MB. For display, what I thought was a GeForce MX200 that was originally in my Joran 750 PC, but turns out to be a Leadtek WinFast 32 MB TNT2. And finally for storage, primarily to save my growing collection of retro machines with games and drivers etc, a 7200 RPM 500 GB Seagate Barracuda hard drive that will be installed into this 5.25-inch hot swappable tray. Here are some of my retro gaming systems that have recently been on a trial run with some network games on Red Alert 2. After taking a brief look at the components I'll be using, it's onto the best part of this project, putting all of these lovely bits into their new home. Thank you. So far my cat Boot seems to be enjoying my build. At this point, I'm still blissfully unaware that this is a 64MB module. In my mind, I thought I was installing two 512MB modules. This is a 40GB Samsung hard drive that will be used as the boot drive for this system, which was not on display with the other components. After that unsuccessful boot, I'd done a bit of troubleshooting, starting with the power supply, which was my suspected culprit, and that turned out to be the case, as the PSU that was already installed in this case puts out just a mere 230 watts. I've now replaced the old power supply with this Casecom 500 watt PSU. For now, I'm just going to throw away the 64MB module and run with the 512MB for the time being. The other vitally important component this machine is missing is a network controller, as there is no onboard NIC on this motherboard. Hopefully, now we should be able to get the system hosted, and straight away, that is a much better result. We have power. Looking splendid, displaying the BIOS from our video card and the post screen, dual Pentium 3 1GHz CPUs and 512MB RAM. And all of our installed drives detecting nicely, 40GB Samsung boot drive, Plex the DVD writer and the 500GB Seagate Barracuda. I'm not too worried about the secondary IDE channel having no 80 conductor cable installed for now. And that, my friends, is the end of this part of the video. Join me in the next part where I will be installing Windows 2000 Pro and configuring my network for this machine to host some valuable data. Thanks for watching, and if you like my videos, please subscribe, like, and comment.